Hi, I'm Mitchell from DPReview. Let's talk about Hasselblad's latest medium format camera, the X2D II 100C. From the outside, it may look a lot like its predecessor, apart from being gray instead of black, but on the inside, it has some big autofocus upgrades and a focus on HDR that make it a really interesting release. Like its name implies, it uses a 100 megapixel sensor, likely the same one from the original X2D. That means its electronic shutter will still be quite slow to read out. But because all the Hasselblad lenses have leaf shutters built in, you can sync them with flash at any speed. While it may be using the same sensor, it now has more AF points, which are extra important since Hasselblad has added continuous autofocus. That should make it much easier to capture moving subjects, especially ones that it can recognize, like animals, vehicles, and, of course, humans. In our experience so far, it's actually especially good at homing in on people's eyes. However, like most modern mirrorless cameras, it's not limited to just tracking those subjects, so you can easily use the track and recompose method. Continuous autofocus is only supported by certain lenses, including the 35-100 f2.8 to 4 launching alongside the camera. But it does a lot to bring the X2D II more in line with cameras like Fujifilm's GFX100 series. In addition to those extra AF points, the camera gains LiDAR sensors as well to help it judge how far away your subject is. We're assuming those are here thanks to DJI, a majority stakeholder in Hasselblad that's been using the tech in some of their cinema tools for a while now. Hasselblad also says that the camera's in-body image stabilization is even better, correcting up to 10 stops compared to the original X2D 7. And while I was very impressed that I could get a sharp photo when shooting a half-second exposure handheld, to me, the updated controls are an even bigger improvement. There's now a joystick for selecting your autofocus point and navigating the menus, and an additional custom button underneath that. If that's not enough, the front command dial is also now clickable, giving you access to yet another customizable function. Where the X2D II really shines though, literally, is when it comes to HDR. Hasselblad has gone all in here. By default, it outputs 10-bit HEIF files alongside its RAWs, which the company says can show up to 3 stops more dynamic range than the standard sRGB JPEGs that most other cameras use. It's an improvement that you can see right on the camera. Its rear screen has a peak brightness of 1400 nits, which lets it really show how highlights pop in HDR. Of course, the problem with HEIFs is that even if your device's display is HDR capable, its software may not be able to open them. The good news is that the X2D II can also shoot Ultra HDR JPEGs like the Google Pixel or Sigma BF. Those can be displayed by anything that supports standard JPEGs, but have an additional brightness map that allows them to show a wider tonal range on HDR displays. Now, there are a lot of cameras that support some kind of HDR output, and you can certainly produce HDR HEIFs or JPEGs from most cameras' RAW files if you're willing to do some post-processing. However, the X2D II is one of the only ones that does it by default. You actually have to go out of your way to take in SDR image with it. Hi, Editing Mitchell here. I wanted to get in one bit of nuance that I missed while filming this, and that's that HDR doesn't work if you're shooting in manual mode. Hasselblad says this is because if you are shooting manual, you're probably going for a very specific look, and you don't want HDR to change that after the fact. So the camera just turns it off. That means if you mainly shoot in manual, you won't have to go out of your way at all to take an SDR image with the X2D II. However, if you shoot in any other exposure control mode, it'll be HDR by default. Alright, back to the video. We here at DPReview have been talking a lot about how exciting HDR is when it comes to viewing images, so it's nice to see a manufacturer fully embracing it like this. Finally, there's the price. And in a twist that we don't see often in 2025, the X2D II is actually cheaper than its predecessor. That's not to say that it's a budget model, because it still costs $7,400, but that's compared to the $8,300 that you'd have to pay for the original X2D. But I don't think anyone's going to complain about that. Unless, of course, they just bought an X2D, and if that's you, I'm very sorry. We'll be going more in depth on the X2D too in the coming weeks, so be sure to stay tuned to dpreview.com for all the latest details. And if you've made it this far, I might as well address why I'm not hoarding one right now. My colleague Richard Butler was kind enough to take ours on holiday with him, so be sure to check out a sample gallery over on the site. It's definitely something special. Anyways, let us know what you think of this camera in the comments below or over on our forums. We'll see you around.